Okay, why? Because they have become the drug of choice now. Selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor. The first selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor which we made was zilmenidine. But this zilmenidine was the first SSRI which was, but it got banned because it was causing Guillain-Barré syndrome. That is why it got banned, but it has historical importance. So now it is not used. The SSRIs which we use nowadays are, the first is fluvoxetine, fluvoxamine, sertraline, escitalopram, paroxetine, and from paroxetine we made a drug depoxetine. Okay, these are the drugs we have. Now let's talk about their properties. Okay, the first property is pharmacokinetic. We will discuss about the most famous drug, that is fluvoxetine. Okay, fluvoxetine, you will write, is an active drug which act for, its half-life is 50 hours. It act for 50 hours and inside the body it forms an active metabolite. So it's an active drug which forms an active metabolite, that is norfloxetine. It is also an active metabolite. This active metabolite, it further act for, its half-life is, it further act for 200 hours. Agreed? Because of this reason, this fluvoxetine is the longest acting antidepressant drug we have. It is the longest acting overall drug we have. Longest acting drug, because it's an active drug with an active metabolite, which is even more. It is the only antidepressant which does not show, which does not have a property of drug discontinuation syndrome. Fluvoxetine does not show drug discontinuation syndrome. Now what is drug discontinuation syndrome? Drug discontinuation syndrome is when you stop any antidepressant drug suddenly. When you stop antidepressant drug suddenly, the patient goes into rebound insomnia, anxiety and depression. Okay, so this drug discontinuation syndrome, when you stop any antidepressant drug suddenly, the patient will go into rebound anxiety. Why? Because the effect of the drug will be over. The drug discontinuation syndrome is generally seen by those antidepressants which are very slow, which are very short acting drug. Drug discontinuation syndrome is seen by short acting drugs. And we know that fluvoxetine is the longest acting drug, hence it will not show drug discontinuation syndrome. So it is shown by short acting drug. So you will write, what are the overall shortest acting antidepressants we have? The shortest acting antidepressant is fluvoxamine, it shows. Venlafaxine, it's an SSRI. Venlafaxine, it's an SNRI. Paroxetine, and rarely by imipramine. Okay, paroxetine is also an SSRI. Rarely by TCA. But which drug will never show? The drug which will never show drug discontinuation syndrome is fluvoxetine. Why? Because it is the longest acting drug. Okay, So let's move forward. What are the further uses of fluoxetine? Fluoxetine, it is approved in depression. The use of fluoxetine is, the use of fluoxetine we will write is, fluoxetine is an approved drug for depression and it is considered as a drug of choice. Okay. Second, it is approved in all types of neurosis. It is approved in all types of neurosis and it is considered as a drug of choice. Fluoxetine is the only drug approved. It is the only drug or only antidepressant which is approved to treat depression and neurosis in people less than 18 years of age. It is the only drug which is approved for younger people in 18 years of age, fluoxetine. Okay, it is the use. Now let's talk about other drugs like fluvoxamine. Fluvoxamine, you will write, it is the shortest acting drug. Hence, fluvoxamine causes maximum chance of drug discontinuation syndrome. And it is only approved in neurosis. It is not approved in depression. It is only approved in neurosis-like condition. Okay? Like OCD and generalized anxiety disorder. It is not given in depression because of very short duration of action. Okay? Third, we will write escitalopram. Escitalopram is the most specific SSRI. Most specific SSRI, and you can write safest SSRI. Okay? It is only used in, you'll write, it is mainly preferred to be given in premenstrual syndrome. It's a kind of neurosis. It is approved for premenstrual syndrome. The second drug you will write is now sertraline. Sertraline. Now, this escitalopram and sertraline, these two drugs are the drug of choice for the treatment of depression in heart disease patient or coronary artery disease patient, CAD patient. Because they are cardio safe. They are the safest drug. They are approved in CAD patient and they are the drug of choice. They are the safest drug in heart disease patient. Escitalopram and sertraline. The next drug we have is paroxetine. Okay. Paroxetine, it is the only SSRI which is contraindicated in pregnancy. Why? Because it causes cleft lip and cleft palate, just like phenytoin. It also causes Epstein anomaly, which is a side effect of lithium, which we will discuss in, which is discussed in bipolar disorder. Okay, it is a potent enzyme inhibitor. It is an enzyme inhibitor. It has lot of drug interactions. And lastly, it causes impotency. And among all SSRI, maximum chance of impotency is by paroxetine. Okay. Now, as this is causing impotency, paroxetine, hence it is an approved drug for an opposite disease of impotency. It is the drug of choice for premature ejaculation. It is approved drug for premature ejaculation. Why? Because it causes impotency, hence we have approved for premature ejaculation. So what are the drugs which are approved for premature ejaculation? You will write paroxetine, and we have modified paroxetine into depoxetine. Depoxetine is only given in premature ejaculation. It is not given in depression or neurosis. Clomipramine is also sometimes used. Okay, so these drugs are given for premature ejaculation because these drugs, they themselves cause impotency. Okay, now let's talk about pharmacokinetics of overall all SSRIs. All SSRIs, they are metabolized by CYP2D6. So remember, fluoxetine is metabolized by CYP2D6. These drugs, they do not require monitoring not required, okay, because they are very safe drug. While tricyclic antidepressants, they require monitoring. Last point, they should not be combined with MAO inhibitor. They should not be combined with MAO inhibitors of any type, okay, because it will lead to serotonin syndrome. Hence, what we should do, there should be a gap between MAO inhibitors and SSRI, okay. So there should be a gap of 2 weeks between MAO inhibitor and SSRI, okay, except there should be a gap of 5 weeks with one SSRI, that is an exception, the longest acting fluoxetine. So fluoxetine requires a gap of 5 weeks because it is the longest acting drug, and there should be a gap of 1 week with SNRI, okay. So the gap between MAO inhibitor and SSRI should be of 2 weeks. Exception is fluoxetine, which requires 5 weeks, and 1 week gap between SNRI, which we will be discussing shortly, okay. Now let's see what are the side effects of SSRI we know, okay. The first problem with SSRI is they take four weeks to produce their effect. They will not produce effect instantaneously. If you start them today, after 1 month the effect will come. Hence, they cannot be given in. They have no role in acute anxiety. For acute anxiety, remember, the drug of choice is benzodiazepines. So they have no role in acute anxiety. They are given for anxiety disorder maintenance. Okay. Their most common side effect. The most common side effect of SSRI is nausea and vomiting. Why it occurs? Because of increase in level of serotonin in one part of brain known as CTZ area. Okay, CTZ area. In CTZ area, which is the vomiting center of the brain, there is a serotonin receptor known as 5-HT3 receptor. So this serotonin, which is increased, act on 5-HT3 receptor, causes vomiting. Okay, hence we have made a drug that will block this receptor, 5-HT3 blocker. The drug name is ondansetron. Ondansetron is an approved anti-emetic drug. It is a 5-HT3 blocker. Let's talk about other side effect. The third side effect you will write, the second most common side effect is they paradoxically increase anxiety in initial 4 weeks. Okay? Why it occurs? Because initially they increase serotonin level, and increase in serotonin stimulate 5-HT2 receptor. Due to stimulation of 5-HT2 receptor in the brain, they may paradoxically increase anxiety. Hence, for initial 4 weeks, combine SSRI with benzodiazepines. After 4 weeks, we stop benzodiazepine and we maintain the patient on SSRI. We don't give benzodiazepine on long-term basis because they have addictive potential. Okay. Third, you will write, they cause erectile dysfunction. or impotency. Now, why they cause impotency? Because the serotonin which is released at the area of penile arteries, serotonin causes constriction of penile arteries. Due to constriction of penile arteries, the blood supply of penile area decreases, and when the blood supply to penile area decreases, it leads to impotency. Fourth point, they cause diarrhea. Diarrhea due to stimulation of 5-HT4 serotonin receptor in GIT. Okay. Fifth, they cause thrombocytopenia. Thrombocytopenia, and which will lead to bleeding. Why? Because they also inhibit uptake of serotonin by platelets. Okay, platelets, they contain serotonin. They inhibit the uptake of serotonin in the platelet. Remember, serotonin in the platelet is required for platelet aggregation. Only then the platelet will stop bleeding. Okay, because of this reason, there will be no platelet aggregation. No platelet aggregation, and the patient has high chance of bleeding. This bleeding most commonly occurs in GIT areas. Okay, so remember this part. These are the side effects of SSRI. Now let's talk about SNRI.